Let's discuss some trigonometric rules used for vector addition. Mainly we are going to discuss two rules. The very first is sine rule. In sine rule, say we are given with a triangle. In sine rule we relate the length of the sides of a triangle with the angles opposite to each side. Say if the vertices of the triangles are A, B and C, and the length of the sides opposite to say angle A is small a, opposite to B is small b, and opposite to C is small c. Now these sides and the angles are related by a trigonometric rule, which we write as, for every triangle according to sine rule, we write A upon sine A is equals to B upon sine B is equals to C upon sine C, and this ratio remains constant. For every triangle the ratio is different, but this is a constant for one triangle. Similar to the sine rule, here in sine rule we are going to relate these factors. And in majority of cases when we add vectors, say if a vector AB is added to vector BC, we are going to get the resultant vector as AC. Now the length of the resultant vector can be obtained by using the other two sides and the angle between them. Similar to sine rule, we define another rule that is called as cosine rule. In cosine rule also we relate the sides with the angles. Cosine rules can be written in three ways corresponding to the length of each sides. Let's write down. This A square is equals to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. And B square is equals to A square plus C square minus 2AC cos B. Similarly, C square is equals to A square plus B square minus 2BA cos C. This is the way how we relate the sides of a triangle with the cosine of the angle corresponding to the side which we are evaluating. In sine rule, we relate the sides and angles by using or by taking sine ratio of the angles. In cosine rule, we use cosine ratio of the angles. Let's see different type of examples where we use sine rule and cosine rule for analysis of vector addition.